Hi, this is Sonia from Beta Healthcare. This screencast is the first of a series of screencasts about Snow Owl, which is software to author clinical terminologies. In this screencast, I'd like to introduce you to the basic interface to help you get started with Snow Owl. When you launch Snow Owl for the first time, you will see this perspective, which is called the authoring perspective. It's a default layout because it gives you access to most of the functions of Snow Owl, such as browsing, authoring, mapping, or creating reference sets. As you can see, it consists of many sections, and I will take you through all of them. But before we start, just a few things about the visual components that are used in Snow Owl. They're views and there are editors. What you can see here are views. So there's the SNOMED CT view, the ACT view, the ICD-10 view, Parents view, Project Explorer view, or the Reference Sets view. And here in this gray field, this is where the editor will be launched. Views are basically lists or hierarchies of information, so you can use them to find a concept, for instance, here in the SNOMED CT view, to navigate through a hierarchy. Or they're just lists that are displayed, like a task list, for instance. And editors, and you can open an editor very easily by just double-clicking on something, on a concept. Here, that's the editor. So the editor displays information as well, more detailed information, but you can also use it to change information, to add a synonym, for instance, or to change the preferred term or add a description to a concept. So this is where you actually will be working with this, the editor. But let me close this again. You can just close it by clicking the X, and let's talk about the different views that we have in the authoring perspective. So the SNOMED CT concept view shows the terms, the concepts of the SNOMED CT terminology. You can make it larger by just dragging this window down. There you can see all the top level concepts, and each of them has pretty icons. I will be talking about this a little bit more in one of the next videos. And you can browse down the terminology just by clicking on these triangles. So you think it opens up the children, and if you click again, it closes the terminology again. And if you find a concept that you're interested in, you just double click it and it will open the editor. Okay. Let me show you the next one. So the other terminology here is the ATC, which is the Anatomical Therapeutic Chemical Classification System. And it's basically displayed the same as the SNOMED CT view. So it also has the hierarchy. You can open and close it and just browse through the different concepts and then open them in the editor just by double clicking, and you can close it again with this window. This is how it works. Then we have ICD-10, which is the International Statistical Classification of Diseases and Related Health Problems. The ICD-10-AM, which is the Australian modification. And if you just click on these tabs, it will always display the view. If you'd like to have a different one on the top, you can just grab the tab and just move it. Here we go. Like this. You can also move them up if you want to, but I'll show you more about changing the layout of your interface in the next video. Okay. Down here is the parents view. It shows you, as it says, the parents of a selected concept. The parents are displayed at the bottom of the tree, structure which is inverse to the way they're displayed in the concept views. So for instance, if I have this concept here, you see clinical finding is the parent, and if you click, you can go up the hierarchy, and now we're at the SNOMED CT concept at the top level. We can go further down. Let me show you this. See, okay. So here you can open the parents of the concept. Okay, so much about the different terminologies. In this bottom section, there are a whole bunch of tabs as well, and I'll just go through them with you quickly. There's the Project Explorer view. It basically works like a file folder that you know from your computer at home. So it contains files that are used for querying script projects and other resources. And you just open them like this as well. The history view is quite interesting because it shows which changes were made to a concept. For the SNOMED CT concepts, the history goes back to over 10 years in time. If you double click on these tabs, it will maximize the window. And then you can see the whole history being displayed here. And if you double tap again, it goes back to where you started from. So double clicking the tabs is very useful. The search view doesn't show any search results yet because we haven't done a search yet. And the problems view displays errors, warnings, information messages about the concept, for example, validation errors resulting from classifying the ontology are displayed here. The bookmarks view allows you to bookmark concepts to make it easier to find them again, just like the bookmarks in your internet browser, and I've already bookmarked a few concepts that are displayed here. Let me show you how to bookmark one. You just go to one of the concepts and you right-click it, and then there's a little note that says add bookmark, and you can enter a description, which I'm not going to do now. And then you see now your concept bleeding was added to the bookmarks, and then you can find it easily again. Commit information gives you information about the latest changes to the terminology, including the person that made the change and their comment about the change. The person is the user ID, and here's the commit comment, and here is the date of the change. So again, if you double click it, it maximizes the window, and if you double click the tab again, it brings it back. Last one is graph visualization. Shows the SNOMED CT concepts graphically. Okay, so much about this part, and let's go to the last section that's still missing. I'm just going to close the editor for now. This is the reference sets view. It lists all of the existing reference sets, and so you can browse through them. They're grouped by their type. This is why we have a hierarchy here as well. It works the same as we've seen in the SNOMED CT view. If you double click one, it opens the reference set, and there will be a separate video about working with reference sets, so I'm not going to go into further detail. Just wanted to show it to you. And the last one is the task list. This is useful when you work in a team and do collaborative authoring, then the tasks will be listed there. So there are a lot of different windows in the authoring perspective, a lot of different views. You might not need all of them. And depending on what you're doing, you might just want to have a limited selection. This is why you can customize your perspective, so the layout of your workspace, which I will show you in the next video. Or you can use one of our preset perspectives. And there are these buttons up here. You can see there's a tooltip coming up whenever I hover over one of the icons. So what we did now is the authoring perspective, and here is the reference set perspective. So when I click this button, it will change. So you only have the reference sets displayed and the editor on the right side. So for instance, if I want to open my mental health reference set, I have the editor here, and now I can make changes to the members of the reference set. Or there's the mapping perspective, which is useful for mapping SNOMED-CT to other terminologies such as ICD-10. And it displays SNOMED-CT on the one side, the view, and the ICD-10 view on the other side. And in the middle is the reference set editor. I'll show you what it looks like when you have a map. Here's a simple map. So this is how it's displayed, and then that helps you when you do mapping. This is basically then your workspace when you're mapping. Okay, if you want to go back to the authoring perspective, just click the owl button and it will bring you back to the authoring perspective. Okay. A few more words about the other icons in the toolbar. These icons are used, these four icons here, for creating reference sets. So depending on what type of reference set you want to create, like here is new simple type reference set or new simple map type reference set, you will use those. These two that are in gray are used for saving, and we haven't made any changes yet, and this is why they haven't changed their color, so you cannot save anything. These three are more for advanced users, such as description logic, classification of the ontology, which would be the cup icon. This one is for doing advanced searches. There will be a separate video about working with this, and the results then will be displayed in this search view that we had before. So if you do a search with this, you will have your results down here. This one is also for advanced users. It's about the concept model. This text field here is quite useful. It's a lot like what you know from your Google search in the internet. You type in a term and it brings the results up as you type. We'll talk about this in a later video as well. Yes, so much about this. That was just a brief introduction to our user interface so that you get to know all the different parts that are out there. If you want to know more or you're looking for something specific, go to Help and then Help Contents, which will bring you to our user guide. There is a Getting Started section that you can read through with some 6 different chapters, and also a very detailed Snow Owl user guide, and you can use the search to find if you're looking for something specific. Okay, so much for now, and as I said, the next video is about changing the layout of your workspace and customizing your perspective.